Why is it so important to take care of our past lives? It is because they keep on governing our thoughts, feelings, and actions. We keep, basically, if we don't, we are not aware of our past, we will keep repeating the same mistakes in every incarnation, again and again. Just do the very same thing, because it's automatic. There is in the yogic tradition a differentiation between samskaras and vrittis. Samskaras are the deep impressions that we carry with us, and the deepest impressions we carry with us from one life to another within our subtle body. We just take them, we transport them, and then they are located in this body, and with these samskaras, we are going to basically interpret everything that we experience according to the samskara, you see? According to the imprint, we will just use our life experience to validate, to say, yes, this is exactly what I'm saying, this is what I'm feeling all along. So we will just confirm over and over again. And vrittis are our surface thoughts, the way we experience our thoughts, the apparent thoughts, the conscious thoughts. Now, the thing is that samskaras, they are the driving force of our thoughts. They give rise to our thoughts and feelings, and as long as we are not aware of them, we are just fighting our thoughts and feelings without any reason. It's not useful. Do you understand? We are trying to work on our surface emotions and feelings and disturbances and tendencies while we really have driving forces that make them come into being. If we manage through our past life regression, through our hidden memory work, we manage to tap into our last lifetime, the previous one from which we just came, that is actually extremely powerful and of extreme importance, because the lifetime that we just came from is the one that has influenced us the most, and the particular way in which we died in that lifetime. This is because this previous lifetime has contributed very strongly to the themes that we are right now experiencing. And second, it contains in it all the information that we need about the uncompleted parts of the human experience. Why we are here again, you see? Now, all of that is completely possible to remember. It's not so difficult. We just need to remove a sort of a barrier and then we begin to experience memories that are actually experienced just as strong as our early childhood experiences or anything else. When you reach enlightenment, just near the enlightenment, you get to see your whole soul journey. Of course, not with every little bit of, because it's enormous, but you get to see the whole story unfolds before your third eye. And then all the memories, they begin to surface, and you see everything falls into place, because it's almost like a rewind. You are moving back in time to all the way to the first moment before you were you accumulated all these memories. But this doesn't mean that we need to wait for awakening to remember all that, and that is actually very helpful in clearing away all the main obstacles that we have in our chakras, in our energy centers, all the blockages, the main hindrances that prevent a complete flow.